And save the time! Get across the time!
Everyone's life. When you have the bottom up, watch it twice.
So Gilly, some very good signs today, just missing that final goal.
I think, especially at home this season, it's been kind of our downfall. I think we've had some very, very good performances at home this year. And again, I thought we played really well. I thought first 20 minutes, we just looked a wee bit edgy, we looked a wee bit disjointed. But again, as the game grew on, we kind of grew into the game, we got a more foothold of the game. We were starting to kind of pick them off, we were creating chances. But again, just that kind of lack of quality. But it's going to come, and again, it's a good point. It's a good point. It feels like 2 points dropped, but I'll take the point.
A few new lads coming in recent weeks. What impact do you think they've had on the team so far?
Well, we've been every day. We're at it every day. Myself, Scotty, Paul, Nicky. We're at it every day trying to improve the squad because we know what we've got just now is maybe just not good enough in terms of. It seems to be the same mistakes. It seems to be the kind of the average age is about 19, 20. So that's killing us. The naivety is killing us. So we're looking at bringing ex-pros in, guys that have played at a senior level before, because that's all that's missing. It's just missing the voice, a bit of guidance, a bit of ruthlessness, to be honest with you, in terms of boys don't set the standards. Like, there needs to be more demands. To be fair, the boys that came in today, it was really good to see, really refreshing. Everything was positive, the demand was there. It's a side I've not seen for us for a while, if I'm honest with you. There's a lot of kind of ratting about, a lot of dogs in there. We were winning the first, we were winning the second. We were up, we were sharp, we were away again. I've not seen that side of us for a while, and it's good to kind of see it back again, because we'll need it.
Well taken goal by your man Jane Burns in the midfield there. How important is it that he scored that? He can kick on now, surely. He's been playing very well recently.
Oh, fantastic. Fantastic. I mean, we tweaked his position a wee bit today. We put him a little bit further higher because he's got that energy. He's got that bite. He likes to go in for a little tackle. And yeah, I tell you what a superb strike. But he's a boy with a big future. And again, he just needs to kind of, hopefully we can keep him. And if he plays another 15, 20 games with us, there's no reason why he can't go into Queen's first team next year and kind of make that spot his own, because he's certainly good enough. But again, football's a funny game, so you just don't know what's going to happen in the future. But just now, wee man's playing really well for us, and again, deserved his strike because he played really well today.
games come thick and fast coming up on Wednesday night against Celtic. Played them fairly recently, didn't go the way we wanted. Do you think the lads will learn from that and will take some kind of lessons into this next game?
They need to learn. They need to learn. We all need to learn, myself included. Every game, you learn from it. I think I got to bed about 4 o'clock that morning purely because your brain doesn't switch off. And it doesn't switch off in terms of it wasn't good enough, it wasn't this. It was trying to find ways to make us better, to make us harder to beat. But again, when you go 2-0 down, 3-0 down, again, it's about heart and desire. And sometimes as a coach, you can't instill that in the players. It's got to kind of be born into them. But again, bringing these older heads in, as you've seen today, we sustained a lot of pressure today purely by having that little bit of experience.
Perfect, cheers.